This is a question that I get pretty often, and that's how do you fix a USB drive that's become corrupted as a result of using it to boot various Linux distributions or Windows or whatever. A lot of times when you create a bootable flash drive, it'll partition the drive with an NBR and it'll configure it in such a way that sometimes it'll make it unreadable by certain operating systems, or at least unable to format because it becomes write protected and stuff like that. You know, I use Image USB, Rufus, DD in Linux, the built-in Mint Image Writer, the Ubuntu Image Writer. There's various tools out there to create a bootable flash drive. Some of them make the flash drive act a little funny afterwards. So I've been asked quite a few times, how do I fix that problem? If I'm on Windows and I don't have access to a Linux terminal or the Linux tools or Gparted or something, how do I fix a flash drive that's become corrupted in Windows? Well, it's pretty easy. I'm gonna plug this drive in. This drive is corrupted. As you can see, it recognizes the device, but it doesn't recognize what it is. It's prompting me to insert a disk. If I go to the file manager, you can see it's unreadable. So insert a disk. If I try to format it, that doesn't work either. If it'll ever come up, there we go. See, it's showing me unknown capacity on this drive. If I try to format it, it just throws out an error, was unable to complete format. So what do we do in this situation? Well, it's actually pretty easy. Pretty much every version of Windows since Windows XP has a disk partitioning command line tool built into it. And this tool will fix this problem. And this is how you use it. We're just gonna type in disk part. This will take boot up the, it's spinning up my hard drives right now. It's checking my drives. Okay, now we're in the disk partitioning prompt. From here, we're going to type in list disk. And here's a list of all of our disks. The flash drive is the one on the bottom because it's the 2 gig one. And I know that that's the drive because this flash drive is the only thing that I have in this computer that's only 2 gigs. So from here, we're gonna type in select disk 3. Okay, disk 3 is now the selected disk. Now we want to clean the drive. This is going to erase the everything from the MBR forward. It's gonna be a complete paperweight of a piece of hardware after we do this. So we're gonna type in clean, and that's going to zap that drive. Disk part succeeded in cleaning the disk. Okay, the next thing we wanna do is we wanna create a brand new partition table. So we're going to type in create partition primary. Just make sure I spell it right. All right, and we'll let that happen. Okay, that was a success. And now we want to format it to a readable format. So now we're gonna type format file system equals FAT32. And we want to make that a quick format. If you don't put the quick in there, it'll format it sector by sector. We'll be here forever. So we'll just do a quick format. We'll let that run. Doesn't take long. There we go, it's done. And look, our drive is back to life. Now, if you did this and your drive didn't wake up, then you would have to assign it a new drive letter. So in order to do this, we would type in active, and that'll mark that drive as an active drive, and then we would type assign, and then that'll give us a new drive letter. As you can see right now, it is drive H. If I assign a new drive letter, it should change. There we go, now it's drive G. See, so it assigned it a new drive letter, drive G. So that's pretty much how you fix this problem. If you have a USB drive that just isn't acting right on your Windows machine, and it previously had some sort of bootable image on it, that's how you get that drive to work again. And to get out of this prompt, you just type exit. That takes you back up to the normal Windows command prompt, and then you type exit again, takes you out. So that's pretty much it. And you can rename it in the command prompt too, but it's easier just to do it here. This is my Kingston drive, so we'll just rename it. And we're good. Now, this drive should work. Let's plug it back in. just for giggles. There we go, it's working now. So that's how you fix a corrupted USB flash drive in Windows. Normally, if I'm using Linux, I just open up a terminal, do a fdisk-l to list the drives, and then I do a sudo makefs vfat command, and that just overwrites the whole drive with FAT32. It's quite a bit easier to do this in Linux than it is in Windows, but you don't always have that option. So I know a lot of people have run into this before because I get a lot of questions on it. And if you're on a Windows machine and need to get one of these drives working again that's gone stupid on you, well, that's how you do it. Anyways, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you later.